on behalf of the family, we're pleading for whomever has Jennifer to please return her, release her, to a secure location.
That was one of the worst feelings of my life that I've had at this point. Too many questions and no answers.
Yeah, the big why. Why would someone do something like that?
For 6 weeks, loved ones remember tireless searches for 9-year-old Jennifer Short.
She was a fun, loving child. She was a smart child, but she loved her parents to death, both. Not one more than the other, but both equally.
Carolyn Short learned someone killed her brother Michael and his wife Mary by watching the news. One of Michael's employees found both murdered, execution style, with a single gunshot wound to the head in their Oak Level home. Their daughter missing.
That took a big chunk out of my life that I'll never get back.
One of the last places Jennifer was seen was at the Circle C, just a few hundred yards from the home. Surveillance video shows her coming in to buy something from the clerk.
She was just happy she could be. I talked to her about going to school, and she said, oh yeah, I'm ready to go. And she was dressed real cute and just happy as she could be, like always.
Search teams and volunteers sent out for miles around the Shorts' home as Henry County investigators brought in criminal profilers from the FBI.
This was the only case like this in the United States at the time, so it was hard to profile. The profile that we got was just very, very general, and they couldn't pin it down anymore because this was the only case like it at the time.
It was during those 6 weeks that family members and friends said goodbye to Michael and Mary. Deputies hoped they'd find clues to the killer and kidnapper in an unusual place. Michael and Mary's funeral. Lieutenant Curtis Spence said they filmed the service hoping to catch anything that could lead them to Jennifer.
Well, we had no idea who actually committed this horrendous act, and we did not know whether they may even show up at the funeral, kind of as a trophy, or the possibility that if it was someone that was close to the family, their actions may give away what they had done.
This is like something, there's like a movie on TV about, like, so for it to happen in real life and for me as a person to be somewhat involved in the person's life, like, it's just kind of surreal.
Caitlin Lane was close with Jennifer in school as teachers at Figsboro Elementary set up the rising fourth grader's desk in class. They remained hopeful she would be there on the first day.
We'll begin the day by letting them cut the yellow ribbons and wear their yellow ribbons to remember Jennifer, and we'll answer any questions that they may have.
Caitlin doesn't remember much from the weeks leading up to back to school, but recalls her mom telling her something had happened to her friend.
Because they found her parents and Jennifer was just missing at first, so I think that's the conversation we had in the bedroom, and she didn't really like give me details about anything. She was just like, they found Jennifer's parents this morning, and Jennifer wasn't at the house. So the biggest explanation, but more so to like protect me, I think.
As weeks went on, family members called for Jennifer's abductor to let the little girl go.
We miss you and we love you very much. Please don't give up, because we will never give up till we find you.
6 weeks later, just over 30 miles away, deputies found Jennifer.
At the time, we didn't know who it was, but we knew that little girl was missing from Virginia. But never in a day would we dream that she would turn up here.